Okay, hi everyone. It's Mike Eilbrock again from Diesel Laptops, and this is part three in a series of the Diesel Tablet software. In this part, we're going to talk about how using the data stream function with your software. So the first thing we have to do is we have to go up to data stream. We have to click on that. We have to let the data collect for a bit. Okay, so everything is on the screen here now, and as you can see here, you've got different options that you can pick from for your graph. So all you have to do is, if you just want to see certain PIDs instead of having to see all of them, all you have to do is you just have to scroll up and down with your finger, or in my case I can use the mouse too. And we're just going to pick some PIDs. Now, I've already got some pre-selected here. Let me go back up. There we go. All right. So to select and deselect, all you have to do is go up to here and then press the screen, and it'll take it away, or then you just push it again to select it. Okay. So now that I've picked the PIDs that I want to see, all you have to do is you just have to go down here to the bottom right hand corner, you hit OK, and now it's going to show all of your PIDs that you selected, either in a digital format, which it's in right now, or you can graph all of them or only select one graph at a time in this configuration. So if you just want to see one graph right now, all you have to do is go to the graph icon right here and click on it. And then here it just shows the graph for the one PID. In this case, we're looking at coolant temperature. Now, if you want to see all of them at the same time, all you have to do is go down here just to the graph and then press on graph. And then it graphs all of them. Okay. So let's go back here. And now, the next features that we have here as well is we have a record function where it's basically a screen recorder. So you can just hit the record button here, and then it's going to start recording all the data on this screen. And then you can go for your test drive, come back, and then you can review the data. In another video, I'll show you how to access all the files and do that, okay? So I'm going to stop that. And then I'm just going to save it. Let's hit okay. And that's pretty much it for the data graphing. Now, there's actually a couple more features. Hold on a second. Forgive me. If we go back here to graph, you can also, now that you've got it in graph, you can combine them all. So here it's showing all the graphs on one screen, which that can be kind of handy, having them overlaid on each other, which is kind of nice. So I do like that. That's pretty neat. Let's go back. And let's click on value here. And then it takes you back to just the regular value. Okay. So that's how you switch between the two for the graphs. Okay. So now that's done, that's pretty much everything you can do looking at data stream. Like I said before, in another video, I'll show you how to use the save sample feature. And then also how to look at your recorded data. So that's about it for DataStream. We're going to end it here, and I will see you all in the next part of this series of videos. So thank you very much for your time, and you have a good day.